45 seconds till we race IndyCar at Pocono. Fingers crossed.
Ugh.
Couldn't hear you. Still can't hear you, man. I don't know about anybody else.
What?
Can you hear me?
No.
What the hell was that? Right, looks like I'm gonna need the tire sets for this. The Houston Velds, everyone's got them, so I don't want them. I know they're proven, that is an obvious fact, but I don't want them, to be honest. Plus they're way too expensive, £1,000 a set. And more if you want the base plate. Keep my distance to this guy.
Man, this thing gets boring. We're in a good spot. We got a beer stand and a pizza stand right behind our pit box.
Yay. Here we go.
Pace cars off. Have a good day. Green light.
And we are off.
Outside. That's the door outside. Clear high. Work at the bottom inside. Still inside. Clear.
That was a move. Okay, here we go. Now the race is on. P3. Oh, I feel a bit more welcome to you here. No, you're staying behind.
Yeah, man, let's get that rhythm out. You're doing a great job.
Yeah, easy. Don't go too far over the banking. Jesus. I'd like to catch up to the guy ahead. am I? Danger is fear. Thank you for the follow. I think I've lost this slipstream. Don't know though. I've regained it. I'm out. So far, really clean. No one's died. No one's attempted to die. Bat marker. That's a piece of wing on the road. That was close. I don't want to hit that. Just want to make you guys aware, watch out on turn three, there is a wing on the road. Okay, it's gone now. Been blown away. Trying to catch up to Edwin. Staying focused as much as I can, fella. Just captured the slipstream now. We are 40 laps to go. Eyes are still good. too wide. Back marker coming up. Sorry if I'm not chatting very much. Not much to chat about. Oh man, oh no, 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 no. Oh. I think everyone's just got his slipstream. Starting to get a little bit of tire fall off. that much fuel left either, so I'm going to need to fill up. Big one tank lasts about 40 laps, or less. Get out of the line! What's he doing? What's he doing driving on the track so slow? It's pitting in, most likely the tyres and fuel. No, not now, for all. Why is the throttle moved?
Alright, we need to be behind the three.
That yellow screwed me.
Yeah. Throttle's going mental. Right, I've got a pit. Someone has came in. Someone's just pitted under no pits. Not to cooperate today. There we are. Gotta reseat the damn sensor again. This is why I want new pedals, because these are just going gone. Nah, they'll be sent to the back. End of line penalty. Right, so we've got 15 litres. I want to add that much.
The road is open.
Alright, good. Right, let's box, because these tyres are slightly knackered now. Right, where's my box at? Uh, Don't see it. There it is.
I wish I'd have been told he was trying to pit, because I was trying to just run with him, but now he was slowing up the pit.
Yeah, these... Man, these tires are fine.
Go. Pit road speed. Looks like you'll be lining up behind the tree. Alright, buddy. Line up behind the three. You're gonna have to come around to 18.
Well, it's really not cooperating today. Just had to reset it twice in a minute. It's ridiculous. I've got to reseat it. Clean the socket out as well for it. Still, that was fine. So the lead is boxing in.
One to go.
Mike's
great.
Hey, you got lucky, man. You still ended up in front of me. Nice.
I think you'll be lining up behind the tree.
Yeah, you were on pace, man. You'd sneak up on me every once in a while, then I'd pull away a couple pins. It was a good little battle.
Yeah, go racing, man. I thought you were going to end up behind after that yellow.
Yeah, I pulled into the pits and the yellow came out. I thought I was screwed.
You honestly timed it flawlessly.
Certainly wasn't planned that way. That was pure luck.
Yeah, for sure. Good racing so far, man.
I almost came in when you said you were coming in. I almost went with you just to be on the same strategy as the leader, and I didn't. Now I wish I had.
Now, this has been a great race. I did one last night, and there was like 8 yellows. It was a complete cluster.
Yeah, I'm surprised it was like half a race with that one.
I've had
welcome to IndyCar.
This week that went caution-free. 2 or 3 that only had 1 caution, and then the rest were this wreck fest.
Good luck, everybody.
Good. 25 laps to go.
Catch your breath. It's gonna be a dogfight, man.
Oh, it's gonna be a dogfight, all right. Fight to keep podium. Let's get it on. No. Oh. That could have been disastrous.
Roger, south. No, what you got when you get in here? It's open. No, close. lining up behind the tree.
Another yellow.
Looks like you'll be lining up behind the tree.
You really can't open these things up on the first couple laps in the corner, can you?
No, you gotta get heat in the tires if they're fresh.
Base car coming out of one.
This is like my second race in this car, so I have no idea how the fuck to drive.
This is my primary series, so I'm kind of used to these.
I do a lot of dirt.
Bottle's still good.
Short tracks.
But it is shifting all over the place. So I've got to keep myself aware.
I'm baffled by dirt on here because I used to race dirt in real life, and I can't. Like, to me, it doesn't correlate. That's the only part of it that doesn't, is dirt track.
Yep, if you can't feel it in your butt, it's just, I race midgets and sprint cars too, and I suck on iRacing.
I think that's it, because like on dirt, you feel the car more, like a simulator can't match that unless you have a motion simulator.
That's just expensive, though.
I would, but I like to keep my wife around. For sure.
This road will be open.
I've already got way too much money into this thing, I can't add more to it.
So the most realistic car in iRacing that I can speak to, I've raced go-karts, midgets, sprint cars, Formula Fords, Formula Mazdas, and Formula Atlantics, which are one step below an IndyCar. And the Skip Barber cars on this iRacing, I'm telling you, they're 99.9% accurate.
I buy that because I did that Skip Barber school back in the day, and I can buy that.
Yeah, I raced Skip Barber against Ryan Hunter Ray when he was coming up.
Twenty-one laps to go. Two of those under yellow.
I had no experience whatsoever in it, but I'm surprisingly good at the rallycross on here.
Put the engine mapping down on its minimum setting. Not one's had enough.
Double them up, double them up. Keep after, baby. I need 20 solid laps.
Put it into its max as soon as we come to the final turn. You want the caution lap solid too? Yeah. Lots of oscillation there. Better not do that, otherwise I'll hit a wall. and that'll be my race over.
Behind the three. But nice big deep breath here. Let's get ready to roll.
All right, once again, we are going green.
Yeah, brother, you do your thing. Green flag's out.
Dirty air. Lots and lots of dirty air.
Cole, that was some fun shit there, buddy, for a couple laps.
Yeah, that's fine. I don't want to wreck anybody. I feel so bad when I do that, especially off of my stupidity.
I'm the same way, that's why I lifted before turn two. I did not want to enter turn two side by side.
That's probably the worst turn to enter with 2 hours.
Safety car, turn one. Okay. Once again.
I hate how these cars feel so tight, but they're actually not. You can steer them wherever you want, but it feels like you're going to the wall. It scares the living shit out of me.
Don't get caught in the dirty
air. The biggest thing I had to learn with it is to trust the car. It will finish the turn, but you gotta, like, learn to, like, have the balls to just to keep the gas down.
Also, learning how to use the wake jacker when you're in traffic is important.
Yeah, because the aero push on these things in traffic are insane. In open space, you can run this lap flat out, but the minute you're behind a car, you got to lift in almost every turn.
And in more cases, use the brakes.
Brake, especially in one.
Okay, we're 13 laps to go.
So when I'm behind three or four cars, I go positive about five or six on the weight jacker into one, and then crank it back down to about three the rest of the way.
Cool, thank you. Basically, positive makes you looser, and negative makes you tighter.
What's interesting about that is I run in a series with Sage Karam, and he was telling us that in real Indy cars, it's the opposite.
Well, it would make sense. It was a more positive one.
That is interesting.
Yeah, when he qualified for Indy several months back, he was in one and two, he was going positive 10 on the jacker, and then on the backstretch, negative 5. And he said the other teams have just a single button where they could just hit it once and it'll go up to 10. But for him, he had an old wheel, and he said he had to hit it 10 times while he's going down the front stretch.
Sage is underrated, man. They just, if he ever would have got a top-funded team, he would have been a damn good driver.
Yeah, it's unfortunate that he had an accident on this track here and that guy got killed. It wasn't Sage's fault, but imagine he was a early 20-year-old kid and that hit him pretty hard.
Oh, for sure. I was at that race.
You look up on YouTube, type in Sage Kareem 26 to 3rd, and it's him when he was running for Andretti in the Pro Mazdas. Man, this kid sends it, man. It's an in-car camera, and you've just never seen anybody so aggressive.
Sounds like a race I want to watch.
Good luck on the restart, everybody.
Good luck. Hopefully we go the whole stretch.
Let's see.
Feel free to fight amongst yourselves back there. Just, you know, leave me alone.
The bounce tire race. Oh.
Yeah.
I gotta see that. I gotta see that race.
About three to go. Utah five probably need fuel, so you guys should pit too.
Nah, I got.
Sounds good.
Nah, I've got plenty of fuel.
Did I mention on the weight tracker that if you're in second place, you want to go plus 20?
Got it.
Map 8 on the fuel map too.
Cool.
I was leading a race, we were going green with two to go, and I forgot to take it off of map 8, like, for the first half of a lap, and I could not figure out why the entire field passed me. I lost that win. I was so pissed.
I think we've all done it.
Speaking of, I'll put it back into map
one. I hit
the gap
and it wasn't going, and I was like, what the fuck?
Get a good dry pull on that thing, get those tires cleaned off real well.
Alright, here we go, once again.
Pace cars off, be ready. Green flag. Flag rolling. Come line up behind the tree.
It's not the best start, if I'm honest. He's coming in on the inside. No, no, he's backing off, he's backing off. They're fighting amongst themselves now. Should help a bit with slipstream. Oh no, it's too wide, it's too wide, it's too wide! Oh. I've got
to
stop doing those close calls, man. Guy behind me, he's looking very racy. He is gonna want, he's gonna want to have a go. Except the problem he has is a lot of wake. That's not what I wanted to do. Cover the inside. Back into the slipstream. That's going to help me a little bit. That is definitely going to help me. Come on, 6 laps to go. I'm losing him. I'm losing him. Just want to stay behind this guy for now. Phone's ringing. Not good.
Five to go.
Not now. Leave me alone. Oh god, that's a bat marker. Okay, bat marker's pitting good. Dirt on my windscreen now. Oh, he's hit the grass a little bit. Oh, this is going to be an opportunity. Come on! 3 laps to go. Come on, we can do it. We can do it. No. Oh, this is going to be so tight now. This is going to be a very tight race at the end. I'm going to stay behind him for now. Otherwise, I'm going to lose time to the guy behind.
How did you two not rest? Holy shit.
Because I have racing etiquette.
They hit wheels and I thought they were both going into the wall.
Catching bit by bit. Oh no, went too wide. Ah, that's my downfall. Ah.
Good race, guys.
Damn.
You're okay.
Ah, that's disappointing, man. Can't believe that.
Good job, man.
I don't really
mess
with that weight jacket stuff, but now that maybe I should look into it. Definitely couldn't keep up when I was right behind you.
Well, I also didn't take a complete load of fuel, and I was trying to burn as much off once we got those yellows. So I might have been lighter than you. That might have been why I got about 3 seconds ahead. Because I've only got like 3 laps of fuel left.
Oh.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I could have caught up. I could have controlled it better behind you, but I just couldn't figure it out on the turn.
Oh, boy.
Yeah. It's tough when you're behind people.
I was so close. I was so close to getting P2, man.
I always had to worry about you. If I could get past the first lap, I could pull away after the second time through turn one, but you would always get right on me in turn two, and it was sketchy.
That was way too close. If I didn't screw up turn two, I think I would have been straight on him. I honestly thought that. Oh well, I guess. Still, that was a good IndyCar race, P3.
Hey, if you crew guys have your radio on, just take those dump cans right over by the height sticks over there, okay? Cool.
Whew. Oh, that was tough. Still, P5 to P3, not bad. Now, shall we have a look at the incidents? Oh dear. Ooh, yeah, that'll do it. Okay, this is turn one. Oh, so wide, got so lucky as well not to hit anyone. Oh! Okay, what happened there? What did he hit? It must be deceptively bumpy then, because look at it. Was lucky not to kill someone. That's maybe where the wing came from. Here comes the arrow. Oh! Oh! Oh dear. That's his race done. Netcode hit. A lot of people not paying attention, are there? Lag. Lap 13. Let me guess. Yep. Same lap. Oh! Oh, set into the pits! Oh, you got a speeding penalty for that as well. It is, especially when you're doing 215 miles an hour. This guy spun into the pits with a broken wing. Another one into the wall. Very green car. Ah! Oh! What on earth? He's slowing down too much. Dear me. That didn't go too well. Oh dear. No, he's been sent into the pits as well. Broken nose cone, broken front wing. He just didn't even try and stop the car. That's a penalty. Hoot this car. Captain Morgan sent to the pits along with another. Didn't look like it. I think this guy's got a knackered engine. Right. Well done. You came out of the pits to go back into the pits. What the incident was, but okay. Oh, that's a broken side pod. And that's the end of the race. That was a good race. First Indy podium. Not bad at all. Not bad at all. If life is a highway, better hit the ground running. We out here surviving. Just trying to feel something.